just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Iowa has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. From the 8-yard line. And he's taken down at the 28. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled at the 26. He sails it long. Big catch there as they knock him out of bounds.
You can chalk that one up to the hundreds of passes the quarterback has thrown to this receiver in practice. These guys know and trust each other, and you could see it in the way he threw that pass.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Quick pass. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. Brought down around the 29-yard line. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down.
It's a first down, and obviously this offense right now is trying to maintain possession, trying to get some rhythm going, and for them to be able to pick up a big first down right here allows them to continue to try to get to the position that they ultimately want to get, and that's into the end zone.
Gains his way to the 13-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he can't get away from the pressure. This is the 10th play of this drive. He gets out to about the 12-yard line.
That makes his third and goal.
From the 12-yard line, it's third down. Gets to that quickly, and down he goes to the 13-yard line. Miami of Ohio could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up, and he's got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line. And he's tackled at the 27. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. There's a strike complete. He's taken down around the 42-yard line. That one's more than good enough for the first down.
Well, Brad, that is a great play by the quarterback to find his target past the marker to keep this drive moving.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. They'll work the left side. Runs it left for a decent gain.
Some excellent moves out there. More than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 40. And they hit him in the backfield. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Here comes the pressure, slings it, and it falls incomplete. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 3-0, Red Hawk. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Miami of Ohio holds a field goal lead. It's second and 10. Ball on the 22.
Badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you. That'll make it 35.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
One quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Ready.
He's under some heat. He's tackled at the 42-yard line. Second and nine. Ball on the 42-yard line. Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
Wow, Brad, you talk about having a strong arm. Next time, though, he might want to work on the accuracy.
Short over the middle. Tackle at the 43-yard line.
These three and outs are quite simply momentum killers.
He's out to the 30. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Miami of Ohio is up a field goal. And he's taken down at the 48. From their own 48-yard line, first down. The Hawkeyes running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up and trying to get back in the ballgame. And a quick throw. And they make the stop around the 46-yard line.
That's a deep system. That'll make it second and four.
To him before he could get back to the line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Makes the grab, and he's got the first. Good open field tackle.
That makes it first and ten.
Take him down immediately. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 29. He's got it with room to run. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Unbelievable, he had a pick in the end zone, and it just slipped right through his hands.
Wow, he is really kicking himself after that one.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the two. Miami of Ohio is up by three. That's a great tackle at the one. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. They give to the tailback. Touchdown, Redhawks.
Was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nine-play, 67-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. It's fielded at the two. Oh, man, he took him down hard. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series.
Dog four, three tackle made around the 31-yard line.
Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Quick throw, and they push him out at the 46-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Throw. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First down. From the 25-yard line, first down. He's scrambling. Slides down to the ground.
The quarterback thought he saw a little bit of running room, but he made a good decision to get down in a hurry.
The Hawkeyes call a timeout. That's their second of the half. He can't miss. Touchdown, Iowa.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. From the seven. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. Miami of Ohio has a 3-point lead. Nice catch. First down. He's knocked out. That makes it first and 10. Around the 45-yard line. And he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Throws it deep. And he hauls it in at the end of that long ball. Touchdown, Miami. And a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
And he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the three. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove it into the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they start to get a little bit fatigued.
We've reached halftime, and there's an upset on the horizon. 17-7, Miami of Ohio.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football? Ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 23-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets it. He's in space. And they finally push him out at the 49. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line.
You know, having a playmaker tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
It's second down. Brought down at the 34. They've decided to go for it here. And down he goes, around the 16-yard line. He's taken down at the 13. Here's the eighth play of the series. Nice run there. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Here they go. First and goal, down by a couple of possessions. Looking for six, and he got it. Touchdown. Nice play as the offense gets it through the air.
Yeah, they've had some success in their short passing game, so they felt confident they could make that play work down inside the 10.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he hits the PAT. A nice 9-play, 77-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Taken from the 3-yard line. He's taken down at the 33-yard line. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Miami of Ohio. Holds a field goal lead. Gets it out quickly. He's tackled around the 36-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
From their own 36-yard line, second down. And he's got room here. He's pushed out of bounds around the 43-yard line. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And he's level at the 45.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45. Steps out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
That's a junior four on there. That makes it second and six.
Complete. He's got room to work. Tackle at the 33. It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Miami of Ohio is up a field goal. Quick toss. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Carries the ball for a nice game. From the 14-yard line, it's third down. And he's going to be sacked.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those as an offensive lineman. When the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Kicks away, and he got it. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime will allow these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive. Really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Going deep. That close to being intercepted. It's second and 10. Ball on the 29. Try running left, and he's taken down right around the 30. Can they pull off the upset? Well, we're going to find out as we head into the fourth quarter. 2014, Redhawks. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. Still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop. And now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. It out to maybe the 46-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Miami of Ohio, up six.
Ready,
quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Well, I think he came down with it, but from up in the booth, it's hard to tell. So the officials taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So they'll overturn the call and rule this a completion.
There was a bad call made on the field, but they were able to fix it because of the replay. This is exactly why the booth review is a great thing for college football.
He's under some heat. Fires out to his wide out. And he is drilled at the 12-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 12-yard line, first down. Catches it, and that's all.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
The gut. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Made
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
First down. They're inside the five. Just under three to go in regulation. Touchdown, Red Hawks.
Don't think that this isn't huge. The game's not quite over, but boy, have they put themselves in a great spot.
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the two. They'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Well, you know the offense would like to generate more than they did on their last possession. Quick throw to the tight end. And he's tackled at about the 37-yard line. Just under two to go in the game. Throws to the tailback, incomplete.
This is simply just a miscommunication between a quarterback and a running back. Now, you don't see the quarterback throwing very often to the running back, and in this case, maybe it got him out of rhythm.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Down around the 33-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. And he's got his receiver for the touchdown. And he converts the extra point. So that's a six-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Was ranking, that doesn't mean anything right now.
Now, they've not played up to their expectations at all, but they have the football here late in the game. They're very fortunate to still have a chance to maybe win it because they've not looked like themselves.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
And he tackles him hard at the 45-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Quick throw out to the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 35-yard line.
Mike 51.
Complete. He's out of bounds. From the 21-yard line, it's first down. It out to maybe the 20-yard line, and he gets a yard on the run. Iowa will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. Looking for his man, incomplete. Third and long in the fourth quarter. If the defense gets a stop here, it might be a W. Defensive coordinator side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. And if they don't get this one, you can start to warm up the bus. Nice run, and he's brought down. Second down and goal. Ball on the nine. Under a minute left in the game. Completes it across the middle. Touchdown, and that's going to give him the lead. The kicker will stay on the sidelines for this extra point as the offense is going to stay on the field and try to make this a three-point game. He's got it for two. A nine-play, 58-yard drive, and they come away with a two-point conversion. So the score now, 29-26. I wouldn't be surprised if they just squib it here. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30. The Redhawks have got to be fired up how this game is going. They still got a chance to win.
Well, you're talking about a huge underdog that's battled the entire game. They've got the football here to start this drive late with a chance to take the lead. You can't even imagine what this would do for this football team if they can put 6 points up on the board.
Slings it. He's taken down around the 39-yard line. The Redhawks will use their first time out of the half. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Over the middle to his tailback. And down he goes at the 50. He's got 300 yards passing now.
He's been able to get up and down the field all day today, moving consistently and effectively.
He airs it out. They've done it. I can't believe it. He makes the PAT. Folks, do you think we can see another Cal Stanford? They need to return this all the way to win it. He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Well, this is the chance. Late in the fourth quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it. And it all comes down to this. One last chance to throw one up and see if somebody can bring it down and win the game. He's going to go for the home run. Can't make the grab. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, Miami 33, Iowa 29. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports, Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.